Greetings, dear classic Benz lovers, and welcome to the channel Fix Your Mercedes. In our today's video, we're going to be talking about the airflow meter. You know, in that video I've been talking about the steady idle. I've been talking about the four crucial components. The fifth one is the airflow meter. If you didn't watch that video, I can give you a link here above. You can find it and watch that video. And there I've been talking about the four components of the mechanical part of the system that must be in excellent shape if you want your system to be functioning as it should. The fifth one is the airflow meter, because its plate mustn't be crooked and it must rest even so it doesn't rub the edges of its housing. If it does, then you're going to troubleshoot many issues, like, for example, both cold and warm starts. The next thing then you are going to be experiencing detonations and many other issues. Well, as you see, this part, I know it's very hard. I know that it can be a big pain in the chest to come to this part, because you will have to be unscrewing the microswitch, the throttle lever linkage, all the hoses from the distributor, the cold start valve, all the hoses from the fuel pressure regulator. I know, but if you have to do this, you will have to do if you experience this problem. Because this plate must be sliding easy, just as easy as like this. So, how do we solve this issue? Let's see that right now. We go from this to this. As you have removed your airflow meter, now it's time to remove the sensor plate and to align it properly so that it doesn't rub the edges of its housing. If yours is the original one, you will be needing Torx for these two. These ones are not, so I need spanner 8. For the next operation, we need the spanner 10 mils to remove the sensor plate. Now, as we remove the plate and its weight, let's see if the plate is even. As we see, it's not, but it doesn't mean that the plate has to be replaced, as they say. The most difficult part of the job is the weight, to align it together with the plate. You will have to be very gentle and patient in order to succeed. You must have to be doing this job very slowly. align the plate and its weight, and then turn the screw in. You must be doing this in tiny movements, and then you deflect the plate to see if it rubs the edges or not. And all over again. Once you're done, just tighten the screw with the spanner carefully and tighten all the screws in the reverse order and mount the airflow meter back on your car again. So, that would be it for our tonight's video.
Please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
And till the next time, happy Mercedes-ing. Bye.